Well, happy Tuesday, everyone. So yesterday, plenty of rainfall, really widespread throughout the day. No real heavy rainfall amounts. We're just over a tenth of an inch or so for the Medford area over the past few hours, and that's adding to another tenth of an inch or so. So we're just under a third of an inch in total over the last 24 hours for the Medford area. And we're very quickly adding to that early this morning. You can see some darker greens, especially for the Rogue Valley and Jackson County specifically, seeing a little bit of rainfall out there as we go through the day today. A lot like yesterday, we just start to lighten things up as we get later in the day. So this afternoon and evening, while we do still have plenty of potential for showers as the system moves onshore, also seeing the potential for some storms, eventually clearing things out later in the day on Wednesday. But as you can see out there, it's fairly active. We have a bit of a cold front coming through early this morning. Won't cool us down too much more than what we saw yesterday. For example, we had that warm front come through yesterday, keeping a lot of snow way up in the mountains. And as you can see, over the mountains, about 6,000 feet and above, that's where you have to go to find anything really coming down as snow. So that's at the tops of a lot of those mountain peaks. This is all connected to a low pressure system out off of the coast. You can see it spinning just a bit there. Most of the energy is coming off of these bands, these fronts, areas like, well, Northern California, Southern Oregon, dealing with a lot of that rain off of that system. And you can see the potentials out there. So the brighter the color is, the more water vapor is in the atmosphere, and there is plenty of it up and down areas of the West Coast. So in terms of the radar, you can see it there. One more look with the low pressure off of the coast, rain, then showers, and we'll start to dry things out as this moves onshore through the course of the day. Today, we're just picking up some of the more intense rainfall activity early this morning, and we'll turn more towards showers, but with that chance of thunderstorms this afternoon. This is what it looks like, a little more vorticity, a little more energy in areas like Douglas County as you go throughout the day, heavier showers there, eventually seeing some potential for snow in the blue color that you see here, but still, even over the Cascades themselves, still a little too warm to see more widespread snow, so it is still on the warm side of things. Keep on going into the afternoon. This is where we start to see some potential out there for thunderstorms from time to time, potentially in Douglas County, a little bit of Jackson County, and in Northern California. These little pop-up yellow streaks, as you can see in the radar, that's just some potential as we go through the day today into tomorrow. But by tomorrow, outside of some scattered shower chances, we should start to clear things out quite a bit. That means a little bit of sunshine at times. Head into Thursday, and as you can see, start to pick things up once again, especially Thursday into Friday. In terms of rainfall, most of the rainfall is going to be over those higher elevations and east of the Cascades, interestingly enough, especially where we're high enough and cold enough to see it come down as snow. That's factored into this. Douglas County seeing plenty of rainfall as well. Head into Wednesday and not adding a whole lot there. As you can see, still very light amounts of rainfall for your Wednesday if anything comes down at all. And by Thursday, another round of rain in the forecast. In terms of precipitation, most of the activity was in Coos County over the last 24 hours, but you can see some decent amounts for areas like Douglas County, out on the coast and in Jackson County. Let's continue and just adding everything up over a total of 24 hours. We've got Roseburg, almost a third of an inch, over a half of an inch further to the north and North Bend, and then Medford, just about a quarter of an inch of rainfall over the course since everything started yesterday. For the coast today, we'll call it rain and then eventually lighter showers. Those showers are likely tonight into tomorrow. Seeing the potential for thunderstorms in the west valleys, rain then showers with that slight chance, temperatures mainly in the 60s, very similar to yesterday. It was actually a little cooler than predicted for Medford, around 58 degrees. And then east of the Cascades, rain then eventually showers as well, 53 for Klamath Falls, slight chance of some thunderstorms from time to time, especially over the Cascades themselves. Rain is likely today, then we do dry out. We'll call it dry for most of the day on Wednesday, but some scattered showers from time to time are possible. Showers will return on Thursday, continue as heavier rainfall on Friday, and that could continue as a chance of showers Saturday, Sunday, possibly into Monday of next week. Checking out the Klamath Basin, that's the trend as well. Rain today, dry tomorrow, and then a chance of showers coming in on Thursday, becoming more likely on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Northern California starting with rain today, ending with more dry conditions tomorrow. A little warmer, a little sunnier. Then showers return Thursday into Friday, with the coast seeing plenty of chances of rain over the next 7 days. Best chance is likely Thursday night into Friday itself.